Hey everyone, this is Tony Teaches Tech. I'm Tony, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Google My Business website for your website. We'll go through your options with that, do some customization, and I think the best part of this is that it's free. There's no hosting fees or anything like that. So let's go ahead and get on into the tutorial here. Right here, I do have my Google My Business listing. It is a video production company called Swamp View Productions. And right now, I have a custom WordPress website. So if you click on website here, it'll take me to swampview.com. And this is a WordPress website. I am paying every month for hosting for this. It's not through Google My Business. I'm just linking through my business listing on Google when my business shows up here. But what I'm going to show you today is how to create a free website within Google My Business. That when your users search for your business on Google, they can click on that and go to your business listing website. So let's go ahead and do that. We're gonna open your My Business dashboard here. It's usually at business.google.com. And let me just show you first off here under the info section, just how I made that linkage to my custom WordPress website. That's down here in the info section. Your link to your website, but we're gonna, like I said, change that to the built-in website, which is down here on the left-hand side on the website tab here. And when you click on that, you get this basic website that Google tries to build for you based on the information that you provide it when you set up your business. So we'll just scroll down here. We're gonna customize a lot of this here, but we have our name of our company, the category that it fits in. We have a header photo, which I believe this was pulled in from YouTube. Okay, so the YouTube channel that was associated with my account, that might have been pulled in through there, or my photos, or my Google Drive, something like that. You have your updates section here, testimonials, anybody who wrote a review about your business, that shows up under that section. And then you have an About Us section, gallery, again, that's pulled in from your photos that you uploaded that you associate it with your business, and a contact section at the bottom. So, they do a pretty good job of pulling that together, making a basic website, but let's do some customization with this. You can do that, and these, if you click on themes here on the left-hand side, these are the themes that we're, at this point at least, we're pretty much stuck with choosing. So you kind of have to find a theme in this list. Hopefully it's possible that aligns well with the colors of your theme or your business, right? Your logo or whatever it is. So I think for me, it would be between these two right here, this like purplish color, darker, and between the fonts, I would like this more standard looking font. So let's see what that looks like up here. That'll have to do. Unfortunately, this is a constraint right now for Google My Business. You're just gonna have to pick one that fits the best. So as far as colors and font sizes and everything like that, that's what we're limited to here. Okay, so that's it for the theme. That updated everything as far as the colors are concerned. Let's move on to the edit section here. And for this button right up here at the top, you have three different options for what the button's gonna say. So you can do contact us, get a quote, or make an appointment. Now, for contact us and get a quote, you will get an email at your Gmail account that's associated with your business with that query from your potential customer. And then for make an appointment, you will have to link this to some type of calendar external service that allows you to have your potential customers make appointments with you. But for me, as a video production company, I'll just use the contact us button, and that way my website visitors can contact me directly via email. Okay, so moving along here, we have text for the headline. That's just going to be in most cases your company name, so I'll change that to Swamp View Productions, like that. And the description that was pulled in from when you set up your Google business, video production service, that sounds good. Now this summary header and summary header and summary body, that I believe shows up down here. somewhere, and I kind of wrote some summaries before the video here, so I'm just going to paste those in. So I have one, the title of the summary is going to be "What is Swamp View?" and then a brief description of what Swamp View is. And this is pretty highly customizable, this section. So I have just an introduction, couple sentences here. We specialize in these types of things, and this is good because we can actually make this a bulleted list, so it looks a little bit nicer. And then if you want to add some emphasis here, I'll say we serve a global audience. I'll make that bold so that sticks out real nice here. So yeah, that's like the About Me section. And then we will save that because that's all the customization we can do in that section. If you do want to add more photos, you can do that in the photos section if you don't already have them pulled in from your business. And then finally, we'll move on to the more section. And this is when it comes time to publish your website. So you have a couple options here. You can click publish now, and this will make your website live at the default URL, so somebody can go to swamp-view-productions.business.site and then they will see your website, but you can customize that. I think just for the sake of having a shorter URL, I'm going to see if I can do just swamp view without any dashes, so swampview.business.site, and let's see if it allows me to do that. Yeah, it looks like it did. Let me see if it updated that. That did not work. Let's go back and let's see if we can update site name. It looks like it took the change. Let me just go to that website manually. So swampview.business.site. And yeah, that okay, so that works. So this is what the live website looks like right now. Swamp View Productions, we got our Contact Us button. And when you click on that, like I said, your visitors can fill out a form with their name, phone number, email address, and this will get sent to your Gmail account that's associated with your business. So that's perfect, and that's built in for us. You have this tab on the left-hand side with a link to your sections. It's just a one-page website, so when you click on About Us, it'll take you down to the About Us section that we wrote here, and you have your gallery, same type of thing. And that's it. That's what you get for free here with a Google My Business website. I don't think there's the one other thing that I wanted to say, if you do want a custom domain name, they give you some suggestions up here if you don't like swampview.business.site and you want something like swampviewproductions.com or whatever your business name is. You can buy a website, you can buy a domain name, but that domain name, at least at this time, appears like it has to be from Google domain. So Google sells domain names, and you can go through that process up here to buy a domain name and customize it that way. But if you don't go through that option, then I think the only other thing that you would want to do, and this is probably a little bit different for you, it probably defaults to automatically assigning this to your business profile. But if you want to update the listing to use this website instead, like we saw in the beginning of the video, when we go to Swamp View Productions in Google, if we refresh the page now that we updated that, this should take us to the business website now, and it does. So that's how that linkage happens. I think that's it for this video, guys. If you have any questions about setting up a website with Google My Business or getting that custom domain name, let me know in the comments below. I'll do my best to help you out. I got plenty of other videos on this channel about setting up websites for your business, specializing in WordPress. So if you want to check one of those out, check out one of these videos over here. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.